thing that a like or a Facebook hit can immediately be converted into votes. I think that would be a bit of visual thinking, at least in this election. But what can be said definitely, as our book suggests, is that influence factor is massive as far as social media goes. So a like, a tweet, a post, a pin, they all can make a big difference to any election campaign and any leader by making sure that voters, their potential constituency of people, can get influenced and therefore possibly taken to the voting booths. Who they vote for is something that social media can help determine, but it may not suggest that every like is a vote. Okay, the Big Connect really has a few interesting elements. One, it sort of lives on the hypothesis that social media is a game-changing movement as far as election campaigning goes. It's quick, it's effective, it's cost-effective as well, and it's also sort of interactive, engaging with people. So that's a big part of the book. What we've done is analyzed the kind of strategies that Aam Aadmi Party, Narendra Modi have undertaken, Congress, perhaps a late mover. Then we also looked at some of the regional parties. It's very interesting to see how the entire social media landscape has been absorbed by many leaders, some who are trying to draw a parallel to what are New Delhi-based studios, TV studios, and the others who are looking to take it away and sort of reach out on a more one-to-one basis. So everybody has a different reason for engaging on social media. Some believe they've got a very solid following otherwise in a non-online space, so they want to convert that online as well. Many of those believe that urban voters have been absent from voting, so the urban youth today sit on the online space, so why not engage with them there? If you look at some of the figures, these are also mentioned in the book, 140 million youngsters are said to come into the polling pool. Now, if that is really going to be a figure, even if a slice of that comes true, then everybody realizes you've got to reach out to the youth by being on Facebook, because that's where they spend majority of their time, or on Twitter, where they are very interested in most of the political ongoings at this stage. But purely in terms of tools, you know, it's worth analyzing which tool is beneficial for politics. I think that's something that we analyzed in depth in terms of strategies adopted by some of these leaders and their parties. The research of the book actually is quite intensive because it's really based on just a little data, a lot of insights, a lot of experience, and a little bit of hit and trial, you know, that most people have undertaken themselves. We also undertook that. We actually went out to research on a first-hand basis on our own by speaking to political party leaders, and more importantly, going onto their Twitter accounts and figuring out what they're up to. Are they following others? How many are they following? And if they're not, then why not? Do they look at it as a megaphone? We analyze the tweets, we analyze the posts ourselves by in a sort of bit to understand whether they really use social media as a social effort. You know that famous saying, go out there and be social, don't do social. So I think that is something that we were trying to look for, and our own research was a big piece of this book as well. Well, I have traveled a lot to vote. I intend to vote, and the intention is not just because I desire change. I also voted last year, but this time I think there's a general movement and that's led by the desire to seek change. And when I say change, it's not necessarily whether it's change of government or a political leader, it's just a change of status quo. And that is something that comes across in the book, because most people who are using social media, one, want to create a parallel discourse from mainstream ideas and possibly a straitjacketed thinking, and social media has given them that platform. I think the youth, if they are truly on social media, most leaders expect that you will be able to engage with them and eventually take a call on who you want to vote, even the fence sitters. So perhaps it's time to use all that discussion on your timelines, all that high-powered, high-energy, you know, expression between friends, to put it to vote. So out there, it's worth going to go out and put your vote, stamp it on at least one of those symbols. It doesn't matter who it is, as long as you exercise what makes you a democratic citizen.